everyone. So today I'm going to react to my 2022 Spotify Wrapped. I did this last year and I think it's really fun. I'm excited to see who is going to be in my top artists songs this year. I think I already know what song is going to be my number one because I started listening to the song in January and I said this is probably going to be my number one song. So I wouldn't be surprised if that's my number one song. So let's get into it. This music you're hearing right now is from C. Schultz. They're really creepy. Okay, so my top genres. First of all, great song here, No Shame. Great song. I just discovered it last year, I think, or earlier this year. I'm obsessed with that song. It's from 5 Seconds to Summer. But my top genres, let's see. Got rock, Latin pop, dance pop, electro industrial. Yeah, I kind of got into that this year. And new wave pop. So Latin pop, dance pop, new wave pop. And rock. Rock is usually, some kind of rock is always in my top. And last year, I think I had Latin rock, and now I have Latin pop. So, pretty interesting. Great song right here. Okay, so my audio day. My night's gothic chill love. That's what I listen to at night. Gothic chill love. Afternoons, Hallyu, euphoric heartache. So, heartbreaking stuff. And my morning's rebellious, amped, exciting. That makes sense, you know, because when in the morning I wake up really early, I usually work out. I like to have energy. I just like to listen to things that are going to give me energy. So I definitely like to listen to things that are going to get me excited and like pumped up and have me just in a good mood for the rest of the day. Oh, I'm bouncing. I have ADHD. Oh, yeah. Look at this song too. Okay, your total playtime was 54,174 minutes. That's more than 93% of other listeners in the U.S. Last year, I think I got more than 90% of the United States, so now it's more than 93%. So I'm going higher up in the rankings. So yeah, like I tell people I'm obsessed with music. It's my drug. Well, music and travel are both my drugs. And I do listen to a lot of music. You don't believe me. Now I have proof, okay? I have proof here from Spotify. 2 years in a row that I listen to more music than most of you in the United States. And that's only on Spotify. That doesn't even count when I listen to the radio, when I'm listening to just things on my phone, like, you know, music on my phone that I have, just other music I have on my computer. So I'm listening to music pretty much 24/7. If you, like, except when I'm with people or, you know, at work and stuff. But like literally any other time, like as soon as I wake up, I have music on. So I always have something on. Top song, Won't Stand Down by Muse. You played it 198 times with the most listens on January 15, 2022, which I think it was... Oh, that's not when it was released. I think it was released January 13th. But yeah, I knew this was going to be my number one song because it was released January 13th. And I said this, I was just listening to it nonstop. It was first single from Muse's new album. And like, I loved it and I still love it. It's almost a year from then. And I still love that song. Like, it's still so good. I know some Muse fans don't love it, but I do. And I knew this was going to, I said, like, this is probably going to be my number one most listened to song. And again, this doesn't even count the times I've listened to it on my phone, like just walking around because I have some music on my phone. Not surprising that this was my number one. Top songs. All right. Top songs, mostly Muse. Yeah, so number one, Won't Stand Down. Number two, Compliance, which was the second single. Then Will of the People, like the three singles, the first four singles of their new album, Will of the People, Killer Be Killed. Yeah, I was just getting really pumped up for the new album. And then All We Have Is Now, orchestral version by Royal Blood. Makes sense. I love that song. I think it's so beautiful. I mean, I like the original version, but the orchestral one is just like... I love orchestral stuff. I love classical music. Anything that incorporates any stringed instruments, like, I will just love it. If you want me to like your song, just add some strings to it and I'll probably like it. But yeah, that is such a beautiful version and I was pretty obsessed with it. And I even learned to play it on the piano. That's how much I love that song. Top artist this year was Muse. You spent 12,165 minutes together. You were in the top 0.01% of Muse listeners this year. Any Muse fans got anything more than that? Because I got that, not, was it last year or the year before? Muse is always either my number one or number two most played artist. So yeah, I just I told you, they're my favorite band. I have a whole podcast about them. I love you, Muse. And I'll always love you guys. And I will always love you. Also, if anyone has listened to them more than me, let me know. You need to show me a screenshot of your minutes, okay? I have 12,165 just on Spotify. Again, that does not count all the times listened to them, other times like through other means. So it's probably even higher than that. Maybe 20,000 minutes. I don't know. You couldn't stop listening to Won't Stand Down. Yeah, you told me that already. All right, my top artist this year, number one Muse, 2, Cee Schultz. That one, if you like really creepy stuff, listen to Cee Schultz. It's more experimental, I guess. That's the way I would describe it. I don't really know. It's just creepy stuff. The first time I heard this was on a radio station that plays really weird stuff at night. And I woke up like 3 a.m. and I'm just like, what is that noise? Like, it was just sounded so creepy. I thought somebody was getting murdered or something. And it was a song from Cee Schultz. But I was like, I need to listen to it. And I didn't mean it in a bad way. Like, it's bad, but it's just, yeah, like I said, just sometimes just random sounds. But I like kind of weird stuff like that. So yeah, I did listen to a lot of their stuff. So if you like weird sounds, music, check out Cee Schultz. And then number 3, Royal Blood, mostly from All We Have Is Now. Probably just from that one song, because I didn't listen to that one a lot. Number 4, Keen. And then number 5, Il Simolo. They're really fun. Like, they just get me in a good mood. If you don't know, they're Latino band. I'm not sure what country they're from. I mean, I just know them because my parents are from Mexico, so they're popular in Mexico, but I'm not sure if they're a Mexican band. But their song, like, if you just want to be in a good mood and like party, they just get me in a good mood, so that's why they're on there. This that you're listening to right now is Cee Schultz, my top podcast. You don't need to know about my podcast. It's mostly just like, you know, psychology stuff. You know, I'm always trying to improve myself. So my listening personality is the adventure. Ooh, definitely sounds like me for sure. You're a seeker of sound. You venture out into the unknown, searching for fresher artists, deeper cuts, newer tracks, especially gems yet to be found. Yes. Oh my God, that is so accurate. You got my listening personality down pat. Exactly. I am an ENVU, exploration, newness, variety, uniqueness. Ah, perfect. I have ADHD, so that makes sense. Like, that describes someone with ADHD, I think. No, I definitely like newness. Newness is a big thing in my life. Just in all different aspects, I just like exploring, discovering new things. Variety, yes. If you have ADHD, you know we need variety. I listen to so many different genres. I do not have really one favorite genre. Uniqueness, yes, that is a big one. The more unique an artist is, the more I'm like, ooh. And it has to be good too, I guess. But that's why, you know, I'm drawn to a lot of artists, because I'll be like, oh my gosh, I've never heard something like this before, or this is just like fresh and not generic. I like this. I'm glad they got my listening personality down. Yeah. All right, so here's everything all in one. So now I'm going to compare my past results to 2023. 2021, my top artist, not Muse, but Luis Miguel. I listened to a lot of Luis Miguel last year, especially because of his Netflix series, which was really good. Then Muse was number 2. I told you, they are number 1 or number 2. They didn't have a new album out, so that's probably why. I had another Latino artist on there. You know, this year I had El Simolo, last year I had Magneto. And then 2020, I had Muse number 1, Michael Jackson number 2, Matt Bellamy number 3. This was year of, you know, COVID when it first hit. Jaded Hearts Club. So Matt Bellamy was in 3 of those. So Matt Bellamy was really big for me in 2020. And Backstreet Boys. You know, gotta have some nostalgia there with the Backstreet Boys and Michael Jackson. So my top songs for 2021 were Butter by BTS. I did listen to that one quite a bit because I did perform a dance to it, so that's one big reason why. Then the next 3 were Luis Miguel songs. They just touched me, man. And then 2020, my top songs were We'll Meet Again from Jaded Hearts Club Band, Tomorrow's World, Matt Bellamy, more Matt Bellamy, and OPP by Naughty by Nature. You gotta have some nostalgia in there, of course. That song is really good. I mean, the subject matter, it's just a fun song, okay? Just don't take it seriously, okay? Then Reach Out, I'll Be There. Both versions, the original by 4 Tops. That alone is just a good song. And then I was really excited that Jaded Hearts Club did a cover of it, so their version was on there too. It's kind of nice that they were like next to each other on my top five, the original and the cover. Jaded Hearts Club did a really good cover of it. So my number one genre last year was Latin pop, and then this year was number two. So Latin pop is still up there, you know, it's a lot, very big in my childhood. And Latin pop just gets me in a good mood. You know, anything that helps me be in a good mood, especially in the morning, like I like to start my day off like well as well as I can. I had a lot of rock last year, alternative rock, classic rock, Latin rock. This year it was just rock. They just put it all together, just rock, and then a new wave. In 2020, COVID year, we had more rock as well. Number one, rock again. Dance pop was number three this year, number two in 2020. Soft rock, okay, soul, and Latin. But I like many more genres than just those, but I guess those are my top ones. Thanks so much for watching. If you want to follow my social media here, let me know like some of your top artists and genres. And if you have beat me with my listening minutes, let me know what your minutes are. I doubt anyone watching has beat me. If you claim you do, you need to send me a screenshot. Okay, and it better not be photoshopped, because I'm pretty good at Photoshop. I'm going to be able to tell if you photoshopped it, okay? I'm not saying I'm number one, but I'm definitely one of the top people who's, I'm telling you, I'm obsessed with music, okay? That's it. Thank you for watching, and I will talk to you guys later. Bye!